I'm grateful to God Almighty for the opportunity, for being alive. It is not everybody born over 60 years ago that are alive. And to have the height that I have attained, it can only be because of God, His mercies, His grace. I'm very grateful. And for my party, the People's Democratic Party, I'm equally grateful to members for trusting me with a mandate to go and contest against the arrival in the coming general election, and accreditation and all that processes took place on a very relaxed atmosphere. But to forestall mischief, you had the heavy presence of security personnel, police, SSS, civil defense, and some military personnel. So under such atmosphere, there were no rancors, no fights. It was a free and fair contest. Let me start by first of all acknowledging his own contribution to the service of our people. In human endeavors, nobody owns the world. As a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, he has done his best. And as far as the people of Ondo Central is concerned, they are very grateful to him. But they think it's high time you changed track and try some other person. I am a professional in politics. As I indicated, I've been in practice, legal practice, for the past 42 years. But I understand about governance. And I know that when you have professionals in politics, people who are committed, people who are accomplished, then they'll be able to do more for our country. I mean, it would appear the people of my senatorial district share that vision when they chose to have me represent them this time around. It is that it is high time we changed track from professional politician to professional in politics. I do not for a moment imagine that it will be an easy task. The sitting governor will want his party, no matter how odious that party is, to still continue to oppress Nigerians. I can tell you for free that the All Progressive Congress has not done well. You know it. All we need to ask our people is your life better under the APC than it was under the PDP? We are rebranding. And I am confident that we will win the coming election. This is because the record of the APC in Nigeria is, for use of better words, unacceptable. You know, marginal exchanging for today about 600 naira, I mean dollar, 600 naira to the dollar. They met it at about 159. You know how much you sell petrol? It was 80 something when they came in. It's going to be about 300 naira when they will be leaving. Security, you can't travel from Akure to Adeokuti without looking over your shoulder. The road is atrocious. How about the cost of living? How about unemployment? As we speak, universities have remained closed and people are stealing humongous amount of money under this government. Someone it's just been discovered that someone stole about 80 billion. They told us they wanted change. What we didn't bargain for is change for the worse. You've been in government for this number of years. What have you done? Tell us about your economic progress. Tell us about employment. Tell us about infrastructure. Tell us about security. Tell us about how united Nigeria has been under the APC. I tell you for free, when President Obasanjo was in office, the current constitution was the one he deployed. Nigeria was not this divided. But when you had this government, this APC government, coming into office, all our fault lines became more exacerbated. And nobody is able to address issues that will unite us. So I believe that when the time comes for campaigns, we just bring out the record of the APC and contrast it with that of the PDP. There's nothing wrong with our society. What is wrong with our society is that instead of leaders, we have dealers. Before the APC came on board, we were not as poor as we are now before the APC came in. Our life was better before APC came in. The Naira was stronger before the APC came in. Security was better before APC came in. A thousand things that were better, but they came lacking idea and lacking commitment to the general well-being of our people. They've run this country aground. It is our duty, collective duty, to vote them out. And I appeal to our voters, do not vote for any APC candidate in any of the elections we are going to hold. I saw somewhere somebody say, if I became this candidate of APC, I will embark on continuity. You want to continue what? Spread poverty, insecurity, division in the country, unemployment? No, we can't continue what the APC is doing. So my appeal to PDP followers, supporters, and the generality of the Nigerian electorate is to use their voters' cards to sack the APC, which is coming into the party. The People's Democratic Party can do with as many good people as we can lay hands on. And Dr. Olusegun Mimiko, remember, is a two-term governor, a former minister, a two-term commissioner, a former secretary to the state government, and a grassroots politician, very astute, focused, and intelligent. So he can only add value to the party. And I can tell you for free that his coming into the party helps us. By the grace of God, we will do so.